ya comienza el TikTok. Likes por Instagram con Jesús Vargas, de todo sobre lucha libre. Y ya comenzó Todo sobre lucha libre con Jesús Vargas. No te lo puedes perder, Todo sobre lucha libre.
Hello, 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 Mr. Santana Jackson. How you doing?
Good, how you guys doing?
Very fine, very fine. So, thank you for accepting the invitation to be here in Instagram Live of Todo Sobre Lucha Libre.
Hey, thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Okay. I think that I listened to you very little. Can you speak again, please?
Yeah, sure. Can you hear me okay?
Okay, let me see one thing. Let me check it. Okay, talk now.
Hello, hello.
Okay, I hear. Do you hear me well? Because I hear you very, very little volume.
Oh, I hear you fine.
I can hear you well.
Okay.
So, okay, let's start. Santana Jackson, for all the fans of Todo Sobre Lucha Libre from Latinoamérica, Japan, Spain, who is Santana Jackson and why you are a wrestler?
Man, I'm just a big Michael Jackson fan, you know. I love Michael Jackson growing up. As a kid, I thought he was amazing. I paid a tribute to him because I wanted to meet him. I thought if I became very good, if I was really good at being a tribute artist, he had noticed me and I get to meet him, you know, but he had passed away. I've been doing it for years since I was a kid. So I wanted to continue doing it because I put a lot of work into all the dancing, the moving, you name it. When I had the makeup on, the transformation, you know. So I just kind of went from there. I came to Las Vegas. I started for a year. I was homeless. So I just worked for tips and donations and charity events. So I didn't make a lot of money, but slowly got somewhere, you know. Then I got into wrestling. I love wrestling already. Big wrestling fan. Love wrestling. I mean, if my stuff was out right now, you would see how much I love wrestling. I thought we was getting ready to move, so I started packing. So a lot of my stuff is put away right now. Of course, my flag's still on the wall there. You know,
okay, so here a message from Alejandra PF saying, "Hi, Santana Jackson, you are amazing at the show in the Tropicana because you have a show in Las Vegas, right?"
Yeah, I work for the MJ Live show at the Tropicana Hotel. Yeah, I work every Monday night. I just worked last night, so yeah.
I've seen your matches and your move. Right, identical like Michael Jackson, and you know you have the Moonwalker DDT.
Oh man, I'm just, you know, I went and got some gear made, Moonwalk Club, you know. The shirt says it all too. You know?
Okay. D'Angelo said, "I need my one-on-one with you, Santana."
Hey, I just said bring it. Just bring it. Like the Rock.
Okay. I'm going to say something in Spanish. Saludos a Balacus, Rebecca Jackson, D'Angelo Colón, Kemita Intensity, Solomon Hopkins. Okay, Christine, I think Michael will be proud of you.
That's what I do, you know. I try to make him proud. I try to keep him in a good light. And then when I wrestle as Michael Jackson, you know, I just want to give you the dancing. I want to give you the entertainment. I want to give you that Michael Jackson, you know, but then you get me, Santana.
So okay. Okay, when you was talking to Michael Jackson, does he know that you already was a wrestler or you wasn't a wrestler then?
I wasn't a wrestler then. I was just performing as Michael Jackson. I was, like, doing charity. Okay. Then. So I was trying to work my way.
Okay, from Germany. Rebecca say hi, Santana. Many greetings, Rebecca from Germany.
Thank you.
You can see that we have a lot of fans around the world. So maybe this question, somebody asked you this, but I want to know the Santana or I mean the Jackson family, how they feel? Okay, because you do a show as Michael Jackson, but seeing you wrestling, how do they feel that you have the Jackson on you?
Some of the family I've met some of the family, and they were actually really cool with it. They actually like it. So I haven't had anything bad yet come from them telling me, "Hey, stop doing that." But it's been all good, good positive feedback. So everyone's been really cool. I've met the cousin Latoya Jackson, and I showed her. So she was like, "Yeah, I like it. It's awesome." I was like, "All right, cool."
So when the Mendes say you always do a great job, a lot of fans you have here,
Oh man, thank you
and
guys so much. I try my best. It's not easy to pay tribute to a king,
you got to do it right.
Gotta do it right, you know what I'm saying? You have to.
Sophie Simon says hi.
I say, ow!
My God. So far, how many championship belts have you won?
None yet.
None
No
yet?
one's put a title on me yet, but it's in time. In time, it'll happen. You never know.
Okay.
You might see me with something one day. One day, folks. Man. May not be here.
Maybe.
It might be
If you
something else.
dream it, it can come
I do
true.
though. Michael Jackson, but
Oh
the
my God. Okay. Ida Tony Granados. Hi, Anthony. You also do lots of charity work for children like MJ did. Tell us about that.
I do some charity work with Win-Win. I've done with Win-Win Entertainment, and I do some stuff with like St. Jude's Ranch, St. Anthony's Hospital in Florida. So I go to hospitals. I entertain the kids as Michael. Some of the kids can't get out of bed because they're in the hospital, they're in the bed. So I learned magic. So I will go there and I'll do like magic tricks for the kids. I will make something appear or disappear. Or, I'll reach into something. So I go like this, and then I just pull out, other stuff like
Oh,
that. I learned
wow.
magic tricks for the kids and just have things appear, disappear, reappear. I got a magic book. I don't know, I put it away already, but I had like a coloring book I do for the kids. That the book is all, it's all like none of the pictures are colored. But if you believe in magic, all of it gets colored right before your eyes. So it's really kind of cool.
Okay. I think that you was coming to Beast Mode Academy. What happened that we didn't see you there here in
I'm
Puerto
sorry.
Rico? Okay, you're supposed to come to the Beast Mode here in Puerto Rico. What happened?
I've never got anything from that, honestly. I've never, I would be there. I've never been to Puerto Rico, so it's like that's where I want to go. I want to try it out, and
Okay.
they reached
So
out.
you
If I
didn't.
reached out, they reached out to the wrong guy.
Well, maybe the people who make me the question, this is Santana Jackson, but somebody asked me, Daddy, what happened with your participation on the Beast Mode here in Puerto Rico?
I don't know. No, I don't think I ever got information about that. I would have been there. Someone else tells me
Okay.
something, I'll be there. I'll be quick to fly to Puerto Rico. Just let me know.
Okay.
I'll
So
moonwalk to Puerto
mire,
Rico. Do it.
Beast Mode, contáctelo porque él dice que no ha recibido ningún mensaje. Have you ever come to Puerto Rico?
No, never.
You
I was
do you
born in
want to
Puerto
come
Rico
here?
first. I want to come to Puerto Rico. You know it. I gotta run around. I gotta see the coquis. I gotta see this. I gotta witness this for myself. I'm gonna go find me a chupacabra or something. I found it. Oh, look, it's a chupacabra. Made him beat it. He beat it.
How do children receive you? Because I know that children love Michael Jackson and all that. How do they receive you?
Oh, the kids love it. I mean, it's surprising to know how many kids know who Michael Jackson is. Because, growing up, we come from a different era. So a lot of the kids didn't know about Michael, but the parents now, they make sure they know who Michael Jackson is. They're like, oh, Michael, you know. I don't know, it's kind of weird because a lot of kids are like 2 years old and they, Michael Jackson, 3 years old, they know Michael Jackson. I'm like, how? This is great. But it's like, ah, they know the music. They know the, I mean, Thriller is always going to play every Halloween. So you're going to know about Michael Jackson somehow.
Okay. Here is a question. Nikki, the freaky girl, how many times a day do you wrestle? A day? Okay. Do you want to answer that?
I can wrestle for 3 days. 3 days. I've done 3 days straight of wrestling. And then you do training, and then you have to do a gym. So it's like, it's a lot of work. I mean, because you got two different things I do. So I'm doing wrestling, and then I'm doing stage. See, on stage, I gotta be in great condition. I gotta be able to move around, dance, sing, and look the part. When wrestling, I got to look the part and be able to move around, jump, punch, hit, duck, and remember what I'm doing. And so it's like it's two different worlds, but to me it's like a choreography, like dancing. It's like you have to learn. You can move around. You can do this and that. So, I mean, it's hard work. Basically, it's hard work. it's you got to put a lot of effort into it.
So because you are doing the dancing of Michael Jackson, that helped you? Also in wrestling, you combine though both. Does that help you a lot?
Yeah, I mean, all my wrestling moves are Michael Jackson fight, you know, dance steps. So I'm creating stuff right now as we speak. I'm thinking of something, you know. So I'm trying to think of new things to make you go, did he just do that? What was that? That's the Thriller move. That's the Beat It move. That's the, you know, Smooth Criminal move. You know, I'm gonna have all these moves. That'll be really cool.
Okay. So Johnny Irish said, yes, this guy rules. And Oliver's eye said, your work is amazing. Thank you.
Thank you. You know, I think that fans are making me some. You know, I'm trying my best to keep them happy, make them smile, and, you know, and do something that I, you know, I love as a kid. I love Michael Jackson. I love wrestling. So I get to combine both of them and do both of them together. So that's different, but it's awesome. So I enjoy that a lot.
Okay. P-Sun 5150 said, blessings.
Many blessings, brother.
Okay, yeah. We know about that. You fight somebody on the street. So Mega Rob said, what happened with the man you got on a fight on the street?
Okay, so I was out there dancing, performing. I was doing street performing to make some extra money. And a guy was calling to me. So I lean in to hear him, and he punches me right in the face. Boom. Hat flies off. I take my glasses off, and then I walk up to him like, hey, who are you? Like, am I on Punk? Is this a TV show? Am I being punked right now? What's Ashton Kutcher? You know, so I'm looking. He's still swinging at me. And I'm like, wow. I'm like, I don't know what's wrong with this guy. This guy must have been drinking. Something was up. But he was picking on other people before he got to me. So when he got to me, I just happened to end the night. He kept swinging, and what got me is when he went low. If you're watching the video, he puts his hand low. He looks like he's going to grab my crotch. And nobody grabs my crotch but me. You know, I do that. I don't need you to help grab my crotch. So at that moment, I grabbed him by the neck, and then with my left leg, I swept him down to the ground, got on top of him. I was going to do an arm bar. So you do see me going for an arm bar. I was. But then I was thinking to myself, I would have to break this guy's arm. I don't want to hurt this guy. I just want to restrain him. So that's why you saw me transition into a chokehold. So I went into a chokehold. I didn't feel like punching this guy or hitting this guy. So I was like, I'm going to restrain him. I'm a trained wrestler. I can put him in a position that he doesn't get hurt and I don't get hurt. Now we're both safe. I could put him to sleep if I had to, but he still would not have gotten hurt, you know.
Okay. Sophie Simon say, I drove over 33 hours just to see you perform on MJ Live. 33 hours.
Wow. You're amazing. Thank you so much for doing so. Anytime Nikki, you come like that, you got to reach out to me. I promise, guys. We're not doing meet and greets right now, but I'll still come out there and meet you guys and take a photo with you right after the show. I'll see you in the parking lot. Just don't tell everybody I told you that.
So here's a good question from Nikki, that freaky girl. What MJ dance move do you do more in the ring before you knock them in the ring?
I mean, I do a lot of dancing, a lot of my Michael Jackson tap dance. And then I got my big spins. I'm always doing spins. So I always got something that's coming. Like I said, I'm coming up with new things all the time. You see something now, next week it'll be something else, and the next week it'll be something else. And you're like, he doesn't stop.
The real Benji 777, enjoy your MJ show last week.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. You know, I try to put on the best show I can. I'm paying tribute to a guy who's a phenomenal performer. Like his dancing, his movements, his singing, his aura. Just, you know, it's Michael freaking Jackson. Like, oh my God! So, I thank you that you know I'm trying to make sure I live that legacy upright. You know, I'm doing it correctly. I don't want anyone to think, you don't do Michael right, man. You need to do Elvis.
Okay.
Or
so.
No.
So you sing on those shows or only dance?
We have to sing and dance. We have to be live on the mic. We have to dance, sing live, all that extra stuff. So you gotta be like, oh baby, give me one more chance while dancing and moving around and trying to keep it sound like, don't you
okay.
See my head's still moving and I'm still able to
Okay.
On, I get home, my neck, my back. My neck and my back and my back and my neck. I can't tell which one hurts the most.
Okay, the rear Benji says, band was killer. I'm a composer.
Oh, word, so, okay.
Yes, so for Sophie Simons, I have a tattoo autographed by Michael Jackson.
I'm jealous. I only have Michael Jackson's t-shirt. I have Michael's t-shirt from This Is It before he passed away. I had a friend of mine's get a hold of it. And after knowing me for a while, he felt like I deserved it. So he literally gave it to me. So I have Michael's last shirt he wore in my closet.
How were your feelings when you see the news that Michael was dead?
It's the same feeling you get when you find out your dad died or something. Or your uncle passed away, like, or your mom's almost, you know, you just lost your mom or grandma. It was kind of like one of those feelings. It was that feeling of, wow, this is the only celebrity I ever wanted to meet. You know, like, this was a top celebrity. This is Michael Jackson. I paid tribute to this guy, you know. This is the guy I wanted to meet. When he passed away, I was stuck to my chair for 3 days and just really, really upset. Like, I couldn't figure out why, how. Like, he just had a concert. Like, I was going to try to catch this one. You know, I was like, maybe I'll see him. Maybe he'll hire me if I became good enough. You know, maybe he'll notice me. Yeah, that was sad. That was really sad news for me because that's the main guy I wanted to talk to. The main guy I wanted to say, hey, it's Michael Jackson. Do a video with him, something. I think he was a cool guy. I think it was fun. I would have made friends with Michael, trust me.
Okay. So, do you sell any merchandise from you?
Yeah, soon I'll have some my t-shirts, and I'll have my sweaters made, too, and I'll have some hats and some, you know, 8x10s and stuff like that. Like, I got
okay.
Wristbands. I'll have some wristbands out there as well.
Wow.
More VT wristbands. Santana Jackson anymore.
Look beautiful.
Yeah, I have a little some merchandise working together. And now I'm gonna have some hats, too.
Okay, so tell us your social media pages and any words for your fans.
On my social media, you know, you can find me on my Instagram, Santana.Jackson7, or Facebook, Santana Jackson. My Twitter is SJMoonwalkDDT. So, yeah, you know, you can follow all my social. If I post up anything else, I have on my TikTok, all that, everything. To be all together and one big collab stuff. I'm working on that tree thing. I don't know how you pick the tree. Yeah.
Okay. Any word for your fans?
Live your life. You know, live it to the fullest. We have one life to live, right? Do things you didn't think you could do. You know, push yourself to the limits. Push yourself to beyond the limits. Make yourself stronger, make yourself better, make yourself cooler, make yourself nicer. Be, you know, do whatever you want to do. Make that now. Do it now. Make a change. Like Michael said, you know, you want to make a change to the man in the mirror, you got to look at yourself. So the only person that makes the change is you. If you have goals in life, like I had a goal, I wanted to become a Michael Jackson tribute artist. I wanted to slowly work my way into doing something, you know what I mean? And look at me now. You know, I started from being homeless, working on tips, donations, you know, and I didn't have to. I have a family. I have people that would take care of me. But I started from scratch to prove that you can do anything you want to do. You put your mind, your heart, and your soul to it. There's nothing to stop you. There's nothing that can't, you know, that's going to get in your way. There's no wall you can break down and get to your goal. So it was like, fight hard, you know, don't give up. There's going to be times when things are going to get hard, things are going to get crazy. You're going to want to kill yourself. You're going to want to just give up on life. That's when you keep on fighting. That's when, you know, you get through that rough patch and you start getting to that smooth sailing water. You know, you can just hang out in the water. You ain't throwing up. You ain't getting seasick. You're having a great, nice, smooth ride. I mean, it takes a minute, but you get there, you know.
Okay. So I'm going to say goodbye in Spanish to my fans. Ahí estuvo Santana Jackson, ya saben sus redes sociales, las de nosotros en nuestro canal de YouTube, Twitter, Instagram y en Facebook tenemos el grupo que usted puede postear lo que usted quiera y la página donde posteamos diferentes cosas aparte de la otra plataforma. Thank you very much, Mr. Santana, for saying yes to this interview. This is not going to be the first or the last one. So be prepared because in the future we're going to contact you and maybe you could be on makeup, so people will see another kind of Santana Jackson. What do you think about that?
Yeah, that's about, next time I'll be in makeup, of course.
Okay, no problem. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.
I appreciate you. Thank you guys. Much love. And